With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Students, I hope you all are doing good. So today our question is like this. During depression of freezing point in a solution, the following are in equilibrium. Okay. Our options are liquid solvent and solid solvent are in equilibrium, or liquid solvent and solid solute are in equilibrium, or liquid solute or solid solute are in equilibrium. And our last option is liquid solute and solid solvent are in equilibrium. So this is a very basic question from the depression in freezing point. First of all, you have to know what is the graph of vapor pressure and temperature. What is the graph between vapor pressure and temperature for the depression in freezing point? Okay, so let me draw it once again, guys. Okay, wait a second. So it will be like this. Okay, I hope you guys are understanding. I am just drawing the graph. Here is vapor pressure of the solution and here is the temperature in Kelvin. Okay, we know the graph between vapor pressure and temperature will be like this. Okay, will be like, wait a second, this is the graph of vapor pressure and temperature. Okay, I hope you guys understanding. This is the basic graph. I hope you know this graph. Okay, when we add a non-volatile solute in the pure solvent, then we know the vapor pressure of the solution decreases. So this is for the solution. This is for the this vapor pressure of the solution, because when we add a non-volatile solute in the pure solvent, then vapor pressure of the solution decreases. And this is the liquid solvent. This is the liquid solvent. Okay, this is the liquid solvent, and below this temperature, this is the frozen solvent, or we can say freezed solvent. Okay, this is the frozen solvent. I hope you guys are understanding it. Okay, so let us say this temperature is T2 and this temperature is T1. Okay, let us say this temperature is T2 and this temperature is T1. And we know delta TF, that is depression in freezing point. What will be the depression in freezing point? It will be T1 minus T2. It will be depression in freezing point. It will be T1 minus T2. Okay, when there is only pure solvent, then the freezing point of this pure solvent is T1. But when we add a non-volatile solute, in the pure solvent, then we know the freezing point of the solution decreases. Then the there have been seen that there is depression in the freezing point. Then this T2 is the freezing point when we add a non-volatile solute in the pure solvent. Then there is the freezing point decrease takes place. So this T2 is the freezing point when there is a non-volatile solute in the solvent. That is, this is the freezing point of the solution and this is the freezing point of the pure solvent. So we know when we add a non-volatile solute in a pure solvent, then freezing point of the solution decreases. That's why the solution have lower freezing point than the pure solvent. So delta TF is equals to T1 minus T2, that is depression in freezing point. Okay, so as you can see here this solvent frozen, that is solid solvent and liquid solvent, are in equilibrium. Here this solvent frozen, or we can say freezed solvent and liquid solvent, are in equilibrium. Let us say solvent is H2O. So there will be equilibrium like this. H2O solid converting into like H2O liquid. So if the solvent is liquid, then there will be equilibrium. If the solvent is water, let us say solvent is water, then there will be equilibrium between water in solid state and water in liquid state. So there will be equilibrium in liquid solvent and solid solvent. So if solvent is H2O, here I am saying that let's say solvent is H2O. Okay, then there will be equilibrium like this. This H2O is the solvent. So as you can see, there is equilibrium between the solid solvent and the liquid solvent. Okay, so during the depression of freezing point in a solution, the liquid solvent and the solid solvent are in equilibrium. So option first is the correct option for this question. Thank you guys.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download DoubtNet app today.